So I've been color grading and editing footage for years now. And while I'm very confident in my skills and my ability for color grading, I always feel like there was more that I needed to master. And I think I finally got the hang of that. This has allowed me to have a bit of a cheat code, like a secret sauce when it comes to my editing style and my color grading and how I want my final image to look. But today I'm gonna give you the chance to make your own secret sauce because the team over at Dehancer reached out to me and asked me to try their film profile product for over a month. I've been using Dehancer Pro for Final Cut Pro. This ultimate bundle is so much more than what I could ever ask for. With Dehancer Pro and all these different film emulations, I have a vast category of different things that I can apply to my footage to make my final edit stand out from everybody else's. And I've used this on my recent independence product that I dropped on Instagram and TikTok. Now I can sit here and go on and on about what Dehancer has to offer, but I think it's better if I show you how it actually works. So let's get into that.
All right, so what we got here is a clip from Junkanoo. It's a yearly cultural parade that we have in the Bahamas. And what I'm gonna do is start from blank. So this is just a raw clip. And I'm gonna basically show you my color grading process with this with Dehancer Pro. So the first thing we wanna do before we get into Dehancer Pro is we wanna add our baselet. I use the Natural Rec 709 from Buttery Lutz. I shot this with my Sony FX30. So this is gonna give me a good base of how I want the clips to look, but it's a little too cool for me. So what we're gonna do is some camera adjustments. We're gonna use our color wheels. Gonna darken that up a bit. Change the temperature just a little bit. All right, so that's like my little S curve. You know, you wanna deepen the contrast a little bit, deepen the blacks. And this looks pretty good for a base color grade. So what we're gonna do from here is put on the Dehancer Pro. And automatically, once you get into Dehancer, you're gonna see you have a long list of things that you can add to this footage. But I'm not gonna get into every single thing, just the stuff that I really use. So let's start with our film profile. I don't like this Kodak Vision that it defaults to, and there are numerous amounts of film that you can choose from, which is crazy. But I kind of lean more towards the Fuji colors. Like the C200 is really nice. 100 and C200 is really nice. There's also one more that I like. I think it's this one. Yeah. That's the Agfa Color XRS 200, expired in 1991. I feel like that's really good. So we might just go with that for this particular one, but I would suggest, you know, depending on the look that you're going for, you could pick between all of these different film profiles, go through them one by one. The look which you might be looking for is gonna give you different options. So let's go back to this one. All right, cool. So we can push and pull on this film. Maybe I want it lighter, maybe I want it a little deeper. You know, you have the option to push and pull on that. I like it like right above there. The second thing what you want to do is you want to enable your defringe. And what I do with this is I just play around with the exposure tools, my temperature. I lean to more like warmer edits. So we just play around with these different tools. From there, we go down to film developer, enable that. We're gonna give this a color boost just to make the colors pop a little bit. And then we're gonna do a little contrast. Do a gamma correction if you want And we're just gonna leave it like that. Now, this is one of my favorite tools. So with film compression, what it does is compresses the image. It compresses the image. It's like, it takes the dynamic range that you lose and it kind of gives you it back. And basically, I can just show you that by toggling it on and off. Like, if you look in the highlights, you can see a lot of the information. It just compresses everything and it gives it a nice pressed in look for the colors and stuff like that. And I really enjoy it. So again, you can play around with these rockers with the color density, the impact of it, how deep you want the film compression to actually look. You can bring down your white point. Bring down your black point. And here comes the final touches. So if you want to look at this now. And you see it, if we cut the answer off, completely different edit. Completely different. So let's go back down to our film grain. Now this is a little too much for me. I like film grain, but this is just a little too much for me. So I'm gonna set up to 65 millimeters, 250, because it's there, but it's just not overpowering the image. And then we're gonna add some halation. That's gonna give it that little red ring that you see comes around the image from like old film profiles when you like clip into the highlights and stuff like that. And we don't want this to be like super noticeable, because you basically have an option to put the type you want. If you want it to be like super known, then you'll have it with the no regimen. Ramjet, sorry, you can have it with the no ramjet, but you just want it to be kind of subtle. Let it be there, but you know, not like super thing. But you might want to look, but yeah. And then we're gonna add our bloom to give it a little pop, and we're gonna leave that at 35 millimeters. I'm not gonna put film damage. We can add some film breath. You can do a gate weave. And then you have other tools here that you can play around with. But these are normally the tools that I use. And if I wanted to turn this into a LUT, I could now take this, turn it into a small or normal size LUT, and do all of the conversions and stuff that I did just now and turn that into a LUT. So let's, once again, see what we started with. Then we're gonna add our S curve back. And then we're gonna add our Dehancer Pro. And that's really how I color grade with Dehancer Pro. And you can see where it took the image from that first image of being like, it's okay, it's all right. But having an image like this would drastically increase your color grading process to give you that extra push to say, yeah, this is what I've been looking for.
If you go on Dehancer's website, I think they give you one of the best options in terms of buying their product. You can sign up for a subscription model, or you can go outright and just buy the product. And I'll take it a step further for you. They even have the separate products like Bloom, Halation. You could buy those separately and own it just by itself, because you might not want to spend the heavy price tag of getting the full program, which I completely understand, but in my opinion, I definitely feel like it's worth it. If you're still on the fence, Dehancer gave me my own promo code where you can get 10% off your order. You can put in DavistCG for your promo code at checkout so you can get 10% off this order. And that's Dehancer Pro. Thank you for the Dehancer team for letting me be able to test out this product for the entire month and give this full length review and use it in one of my projects. So if you want to take your footage up to the next level, or you want to get a specific film look for a certain project, check out Dehancer Pro. I see y'all in the next one.